Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threats. In case you are here for the first time, do consider subscribing and also hit the bell icon to get all the video updates. So in today's video, we'll learn how to make this crocheted flower design. So this design has been posted in the past a couple of times, but unfortunately has no explanation, and a few of you have been messaging me to redo it with explanation, and that is the reason I'm here today. In case you guys already know how to do this design, you can please skip from here, and others who want to learn can continue. So now, without any delay, let's get started. I'm using crochet hook number 10 along with 6 strands of silk thread. I am starting with black color. I'm just going to use 2 colors, which is pink and black. The first step is going to be in black. So starting off with the right side of the sari facing on top, like always. The first step is to make our base, which is a 4 chain base. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. And then we'll fix this using a single crochet. Again, 4 chains and 1 single crochet. So we'll have to work this base till we reach the other end of the sari. I have finished working the 4 chain base and I've turned the sari. Now we'll just work the second step. I'm going to continue in the same color. Start with 5 chains. 3, 4 and 5. And then 1 double crochet in the same chain block. So 2 chains and 1 more double crochet in the same block. So in this block, in each block, we are supposed to have 4 double crochets. So this 3 chain, the starting 3 chain will act as 1 double crochet and then 2 chains. So the next double crochet, 2 chains, double crochet, 2 chains and double crochet. So we have 4 stitches in the first one. So now I'm going to make double crochet in the next block. So this is how this step will continue. 2 chains and double crochet 4 times in each block. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches again. So just continue till the end. So I've finished this step in black. I've cut the thread and I've pulled it out. So this is where I'm going to join the second color, which is pink. So holding both the colors together, I'm just going to make 2 knots. I've just taken 5 strands of pink. I'm just going to make 1 more knot. And in this step, we'll also need gold beads like this. You can use 3mm kuchu beads or this kind of metal beads. So we'll start off with working a single crochet in the first stitch here. And then make 2 chains and 4 double crochets in this 2 chain gap. So the first two chains will also count as a double crochet. So that way in total we are working 5 double crochets. So after 4 double crochet stitches, we'll have to just work 1 single crochet in the double crochet of the previous row. Continue the same thing 5 more times. So 2 chains, which acts like our first double crochet, and then 4 double crochets, all in the same place. And then single crochet on this stitch. So repeat the same thing 4 more times. So here I've worked 6 petals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and I've already made 1 single crochet in this stitch. So now we'll have to just pull this and loop it like this, and we'll go back right here, like below this one here, is in below the first petal, and then get this loop from here and work one chain. So when we do this, this will actually look like a flower. So after one chain, we'll start with again one chain, and as usual, double crochets in the next chain block here. Four double crochets again in the same place. So after 4 stitches, again 1 single crochet in this previous stitch, 2 chains, 4 double crochets again in the next one. Again 1 single crochet in this one. So this is how the flower will spread out. So in this chain space, we'll again do the same thing, but after 2 double crochets, we'll add 1 bead and then work 2 more double crochets. So this is the bead. Slide it in, work 2 more double crochets in the same place. And then 1 single crochet. So before we start our next flower, in the next 2 chain loops, we'll just have to do this part and then start off with the next flower. So I've worked 6 petals, that is excluding these 2 here. Now we'll again make the flower. So where we'll go in is 1 and 2 we are going to skip, that which is after the bead. So I'm going to go in here. And then chain 2, start off with this part. After working the complete sari, I've also tied tassels. I am not showing this part because I've posted lots and lots of videos on how to tie tassel. So for this one, I've just used 120 strands of silk thread. I have just added one golden yellow here and there because there is very little golden yellow in the sari. And moreover, the body is pink. So when this falls on this, if it is contrast color, it will be more highlighted. So now we will just stick the flower beads in this gap. So this is how it looks once it is complete. So the final step is to just stick these flower beads using fabric glue. If you don't want, you can completely skip this step. It is completely optional. And if you don't want these kind of beads, you can simply stick some jharkan or even kundans of your choice. So how I have done that is just using fabric glue. Just apply very little glue. You'll have to be very careful while working with fabric glue because it will leave stains on the sari. Then just stick it like this. So once you do this, allow it to dry for at least 30 to 40 minutes before you move the sari. Let it be flat like this so that it glues well and the beads won't fall off very soon. So this is how it looks once it is complete. I would not say this is a beginner level design. If you need to know a little bit of more of crochet to do this design. In case you're trying crochet for the first time, then this is definitely not the design to try. You can start off with some simple designs and then try something like this. So I hope you guys like this video. In case you do, please give us a thumbs up and also leave your comments in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, follow us on Pinterest, Facebook and Instagram. Also consider becoming a member by clicking that join button next to the subscribe button. Also, one last request, subscribe to our other channel Naughty Vlogs, where I am posting all Kannada videos. You can send me your requests, whichever designs you want me to redo in Kannada, I will be more than happy to do that for you guys. So I guess that's about it for today. All the material I have used in this video is available on naughtythreads.com, so please do take a look, and I guess it's time to sign off now. I'll see you soon in my next video, guys. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.